Welcome all, it's Russ, and in this video we're going to talk about some basic file processing. Alright, so the first thing you need to do when you're going to open up a file is that you're going to need to call the open function. So here we'll say the variable f equals open data.txt. All right, so open is going to look for the file data.txt. If it exists, then it will go ahead and actually read it. Now, F is going to be what's called a file object. It's an object that represents this open file as we read it. Now, one of the ways that we'll be reading over files is that we'll be looping over them, but I haven't shown you loops yet. So right now, I'm going to show you some of the more basic ones you can do. First of all, is that you can say x equals f dot readline. Now, x, the readline function works essentially like the input function does, but instead of reading from the keyboard, it's going to read from this file. Now, the one noteworthy distinction about readline is that readline will include the new line at the end of the line. So if we've got a file here that contains, you know, dad, mom, Russ, and Ben, then when you call readline on it the first time, what you're going to get is actually a 4-character string. It's going to be the string that looks like this. It has a D, then it has an A, then it has another D, and then it has the new line character. We'll talk more about the new line character in a future video, but the new line character is basically the one that takes you from this line down to the next. Now, do you need to worry about this new line character? Depends on how you're going to process the line. But very often, the first thing that we're going to do with anything we read from a file is that we may do a strip or a split on it. If you do a strip or a split on it, then don't worry. New line characters count as white space and they'll be simply removed. However, if you're not going to do strip, then you should think about it. If you want to read a whole bunch of lines, you can call readline multiple times. Y equals f dot readline. In just the same way that you can call input multiple times. Another handy one that you might want to do is that instead of calling readline singular, you can call readlines plural. What this will return is an array containing all of the strings that you would have gotten if you did readline from the top of the file all the way down to the bottom. The last thing that you might do, this is more rare, not likely to do it in this class, but I don't know, possible, is you could call read itself. And read simply says, I want you to return me the entire file as a string. And so in the case of like dad, mom, Russ, Ben, what you get is the string dad, new line, mom, new line, Russ, and so on. So those are the key ones. Readline is the one you're most likely to use. Readlines is also good. Read is interesting. The last thing you ought to do is that you should get in the habit of always closing your files. F.close. Now, when you're reading an input file, closing it is not, it can occasionally be a problem, but in the simple programs we're going to write in this class, you're not likely to hurt yourself if you don't close it. However, later on, if we do a program that requires you to write out to a file, if you don't close it, then the write will actually not complete. So get yourself in the habit. You might as well be in the habit now. Anytime you open a file, make sure you close it as well. So those are the basics of file handling. We'll get a lot more interesting stuff when we finally have loops to work with, but that's coming up in a later video. So hope you've learned a good amount here. I'll see you later. Bye-bye.